folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the absolute pleasure of sharing with you the differences between the Gibson Les Paul Standard 50s and 60s. Two iconic guitars that look and do the same thing. They're bloody Les Pauls, one of the most iconic guitars on the entire planet. Great looking, great sounding, and they feel amazing. But there are some subtle differences between the 50s and the 60s that you might not know about. So we're going to talk about that in this video. Whether it's a 50s or a 60s Les Paul, they are bloody fantastic to play. They're just, it's a Les Paul, the course is fantastic. As always with these kinds of videos, if you want to expand on anything that I talk about or add anything, please comment down below and share the love. Now I'm not going to go too in-depth into the history of the Les Paul. There's videos here on the channel PMTVUK. I'll link that in the description box down below. Or you can comment it because the history is very rich and very beautiful, but I'll be here all day. First off, let's talk about the differences between the two. Now before you even pick up one of these Les Paul standards, you'll notice that the 50s and the 60s share different colours. So there's some colours you can only get in the 50s and some colours you can only get in the 60s variant of the Gibson Les Paul standard. I'm not going to go into all the fantastic colours. If you want to check out all the colours available, linked in the description box down below, you can get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk and bask in their wonderful glory. One thing I'll say as well is you can only get a Les Paul standard P90 variant in the 50s, because that's what the Les Paul was all about before 1957. You'd only get a P90 and a Les Paul simply because the humbucker wasn't yet invented. So the P90s only come in the 50s spec. There is also, you've got to remember, the Les Paul Deluxe 70s version which is available now with the mini humbuckers, but that's a kind of different video completely because Gibson had a crazy time in the 70s. These are Les Paul standards. That one's classed as a deluxe, so if you're here for that, keep waiting a bit longer. I'll do a video on that soon. Put this 50s down, it's fantastic. This is the tobacco burst finish. As you can see, this is unburst in the 60s. Now I chose this because it's one of the newer colors for Gibson. Like, everyone's familiar with the vintage sunburst, tobacco sunburst, cherry sunburst, gold tops and stuff. Iced tea is one of my personal favorites. You can also get that in the 60s, but I thought I'd choose unburst because it's slightly peculiar. Now one thing that is peculiar is a lot of the specs online, Gibson sites and other sites, will say the 50s, which is this one, features a maple top, which is true, and the 60s features a AA maple top, so in essence a higher grade maple top. This is classed as a lower top than that, so I think it is literally just go to check out the guitar, get your PMT store to send a picture, because you can't do that obviously, send a picture of the top so you can pick your specific tops, pick your specific flame. So on paper the 60s has a different kind of top, double A flame maple, as opposed to just regular maple top, but that's pretty damn flamey to me. I'd rate that as double A or triple A. It's fantastic. So that is a difference, but also doesn't really change the world. I think it's fantastic. Another difference you'll see before you even pick up your Les Paul standard is simply the aesthetic nature of the knobs. The 50s have the amber top hat knobs. The 60s have the top hats with the little mirror reflectors on the top. So if you're not familiar with the colors of the Les Paul standards, 50s or 60s, you can immediately tell them apart by the 60s has the little mirror reflector tops and the 50s doesn't, because that's how it was back in the day. Right, so that's just looking at it. Let's pick up the Les Paul standards, and what's the first thing you notice when you pick them up? Of course, the neck profile. Before you even plug it in, you feel the neck and feel how bloody lovely it is, whether it's the 50s or the 60s. So the 50s has a slightly chunkier neck. It has a 50s profile with more of a rounded kind of shoulder to it. It's not too big. It's not like a big baseball bat, Fender Tele Esquire neck. It's still a very comfortable neck. You can get some bigger necks in, say, the custom shops, the 50's custom shops, which are a bit more akin to the original 50's, but those necks aren't for everyone. Some people don't like big chunky necks, but they still want a 50s inspired guitar, so this is a bit more, it's a 50s profile. It's what's known these days as a 50s profile. There's a bit more to it than the slim taper neck you'll find on the 60s Les Paul. This is a much more common Gibson neck. They've used this neck for years. They've used this neck for a long time, but the slim taper is a very familiar Gibson neck, all you Les Paul players out there will realize. And yeah, a bit thinner, not too thin. It's not like an Ibanez gem. It's just ever so slightly thinner than the 50s more rounded profile. But like, it's not the kind of thing where you play a two and go, oh, that's ridiculously thin, that the necks are totally different. They're still very, very comfortable necks, but going from one or the other, you can't tell it. So if you can get into your local PMT store and try out a 50s and a 60s, if you're debating buying a Les Paul Standard, one might sing with you a bit more. Again, I'm not saying one's better or worse than the other. It's all personal preference. If you're undecided, buy them both. And I'm sure the PMT folk will give you a little discount if you buy two Les Pauls at once. One little thing I forgot to mention about the aesthetics, and obviously this has a part to play as well, is the tuner pegs. So up at the headstock of your Les Paul Standard, you'll find the vintage style cloisons on the 50 with the lovely like greeny cream tulip buttons on the end. And in the 60s, you'll find the Grovers, the Grover tuners, which were, it's more the case that everyone, there's nothing wrong with the cloisons. I love cloisons, they're fantastic, but a lot of people changed them over to Grovers, like modified their 50s Les Pauls back in the day, Jimmy Page, to name Clapton, put Grovers on as well. So that's another little aesthetic difference. And the Grovers do, they're a bit heavier tuners. You can't tell really at all when you pick up your Les Paul because they're a big, wonderful beast anyways, but forums online will tell you that Grovers have a bit more mass. And if you're one of the folk out there, I am to an extent, that think that mass adds sustain to a guitar. The more mass that's there adds sustain. That's a factor to consider with the chrome Grovers up top. But yeah, that's another difference between the 50s and the 60s Les Paul Standard. So those are the differences you can see and feel and touch. One of the main differences between the two are the pickups. Obviously they're adorned with wonderful Gibson pickups. In the 50s, you've got the 50 Standard and the 61 treble and rhythm pickup burst buckers in the 60s. Now again, two very, very classic pickups. One necessarily isn't better than the other, but they do sound quite different. Got Alnico 2 magnets in the 50s and Alnico 5 magnets in the burst buckers in the 60s. Now these are a lot warmer, have less bite, but they've got that creaminess, they've got that 50s kind of warmth and creaminess, that kind of, you know. There's a bit more snap to the burst booker 61 R&T in the 60s. But I've got to stress this, if you're watching this on your phone or something, even with headphones, YouTube does compress everything quite a bit. If you really want to feel the full force of these guitars, you gotta get yourself to your local PMT store and try them out for yourself, because there are subtle differences, but that, again, one's not better than the other. Totally up to you. For me, I think I'll go 50s, I think. I don't know. What would you choose? Let me know down below in the comments. This also as well, it goes for Epiphone. So a lot, like, I know they haven't got the Gibson bits and bobs on, but the 50s and 60s Epiphones also do share different neck profiles and things of this ilk, which do separate them. It's more than just different finishes and different names on the website. There are some subtle differences which make them unique to themselves, but just different. One's not worse, not better. I mean, that still has obviously got some bite, it's just not as creamy, let's say. So those are the main differences you'll find between the 50s and the 60s Les Paul Standard. Let's talk about the similarities and what makes them a proper Les Paul. They both obviously share that 24 and 3 quarters inch scale length, mahogany construction, so mahogany body with that set mahogany neck we all know and love. It's that recipe that we all love the taste of, so why would you ever change it? Again, with that maple top. One volume for each pickup, one tone for each pickup. They both feature CTS pots and orange drop capacitors. They've got little thumb bleeder pointers on the control control knobs as well. Again, the difference only being the reflectors on the top. Tune-o-matic bridge, stop bar tailpiece, rosewood fingerboard, 12-inch radius with 22 medium jumbo frets. You've got the Graphtec nut up top. It's a bloody Les Paul, one of the best sounding guitars on the entire planet. And I hope you've enjoyed this little rundown, let's say, of the differences between the 50s and the 60s. Let us know what you think. What's your favorite? This has been a lot of fun. Comment down below again what you think. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. Any more information on these Les Pauls? Everything's linked in the description box down below. We are playing music today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. I've been Dagan. It's been a pleasure. I'll see you next time.